Hey guys, welcome back to Licklibrary and today's free guitar lesson. My name is Mitch Laddie and in today's video I want to talk to you about playing slow blues solos. And what I'm really going to be giving you here today is 5 tips that have really helped me along the way when playing over those slow blues progressions and R&B progressions, soul progressions, all this kind of thing. And when we play slowly, we tend to rush notes and get caught up in kind of trying to sound the best we can, but that often means we forget our fundamentals, all those expressive qualities that we need to really make our solo section in a song sing. So everything I'm going to be talking about today in the video is timestamped in the description, but without further ado, let's talk about tip number one. Now this one might seem like a no-brainer, but it is concentrate on your tone. Now whether we do everything within a DAW, or we like to use our favorite amps, pedals, and pedal combinations for achieving our tonal results. In today's age, there is a multitude of great options for achieving good tone quickly. So it's never something we should skip over. But most importantly, why we shouldn't skip over it is because we should be listening to whatever we are playing over. If we have the opportunity to play over a slow song, then we want the guitar to be heard. And we want that guitar tone to sound good within the context of the song that we're playing over, right? Of course we do. So don't skip over it at the beginning. At the end of the day, it all comes down to feel. And if you're not feeling the tone, it's probably gonna come through in your playing. So tip number one is concentrate on that tone. Tip number two is less is more. It's a cliche for a reason, but really what I'm talking about here is taking our time. We don't want to be flying through scale shapes and overusing the notes within our scale and not listening to the context of what we're playing over. Get to know the progression, the chords, how they interact with each other, and remember, don't panic. Take time to feel what you're playing and make every note count. Tip number three is taking advantage of expressive techniques. I'm talking about vibrato, bends, bends with vibrato, and slides with vibrato too. These are the cornerstones of expressive guitar playing. We're trying to think like a human voice here, like a slide player would do. One thing I like to do to get that slide emulation, that vocal technique, is to take one string. Okay, so I'm in the key of G, I'm taking the B string, and I'm just taking those notes up here from the 3rd fret and just going up the string. I'm gonna grab that minor 3rd and go back. But what we do is we slide. So even there, I'm sliding straight in and straight out of that note a few times. You can do it on other strings too. That slide in and out. Back to the root note. Let's hear some of these ideas in context with a track. Chordal harmony can be a great way to get some life into your playing. And for me, one thing to use is chordal couplets. Why? Because they're so easy to use. All we're talking about here is 2 notes at a time from a chord shape. So let's say here we have this G major. Now all we're really doing is using these notes within the scale. But if we pair that with our expressive techniques like a slide, Throw in some hammer-ons and some pull-offs, and we start to get that sound of the chordal harmony, but in a really expressive way, which is something that we can build upon and get the best out of in a slow situation. Let's have a listen to this in context with the track. The harmonic minor scale can be a really great way to introduce some of that sophistication and exotic flavor into your playing. And we can do it easily because we only have to change one note from the minor scale. Now let's check out our normal minor scale shape here. Our natural minor, I'm starting here on this box position, starting at the A string, 7th fret. Now we're going to change that 7th note. Now what we get there is something that sounds a bit strange, but when we put it in context, we can get some cool licks. Let's have a listen to this in context, as well as everything else we've talked about, over a minor blues set. There we have it, my 5 tips for playing better slow blues solos. I hope you enjoyed the video, and if you did, be sure to subscribe to our channel and drop us a comment there and let us know if there is anything that you want us to cover, any specific lessons or content. We do check those comments, so be sure to let us know. Also, be sure to head over to licklibrary.com where you can get lessons on hundreds of track breakdowns of your favorite artists, playthroughs. You can even get one-to-one support as part of your membership. So, until next time, take care.